The homeless situation in the car? Sure, but at the same your dad. Sure. I'm No, tell me the truth. Kick it real. Sure, but how is that supposed to even happen? How is that supposed to even, like, for example, how am I supposed to have a fair chance? How am I supposed to have a fair chance to my daughter again if I'm being cock blocked by her father and his wife? Like, you don't even understand how hurtful it is at the fact that you call another bitch mother. I've heard you on the phone talking to your friends, and you'll fucking call that hoe, that dirty ass, skanky ass, low life hoe mother. You'll compare her to a title that I worked very hard for. And I gotta be honest, excuse me, freeze frame. Let me finish my motherfucking angry thought, okay? No, because at the end of the fucking day, if it was a competition, let me finish my thought, Tiani. If it was a competition between. Right, but you gave it to her. You lent her my fucking title, and this hoe tried to take over my role. Let me finish. Let me finish. Let me finish because she was goddamn right there. Because your dad doesn't think for himself. He thinks through Toya. Period. That's a sad, 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 terrible thing. Because if it was a competition, let me finish my thought, Tiani. Then that's unfortunate because there's a lot of fucking kids. There's a lot of kids who have been homeless. Sure, but that's the thing. Okay. Here's what I want. I want for you to let me talk and say a complete sentence without you interrupting and using your emotions. Okay, so you're going to do this again. You are so good at keeping order in terms of who's supposed to be talking when you can't just shut the fuck up when you hear your mother's voice. Keep keeping track, Tiana. Keep keeping track. You know what, Tiani? One day, you're not going to hear my voice, and you're going to feel very fucking stupid for all those fucking times you cut me off and you didn't let me make my fucking point and say what I needed to say. Obviously, what you have to say must be so fucking important. Let me hear it. Here's the bottom fucking line, kid. Bottom fucking line is that people go through extenuating circumstances in life, such as job loss, such as I'm not dismissing you. No, I'm not. Just because I didn't pick up. Right, because just because I didn't pick up where you left off doesn't mean I'm dismissing you. It means you just interrupted me a third fucking time, and I can never get to your point. Not gonna work. Because on that, you're not the adult. Absolutely. But at the same time, if you don't allow the person you're talking to, whether I'm an adult or a child, like one of your peers, to complete my thought so I can get to your point, then you're always going to... I'm going to ask you again. What is your point? I'm apologizing for not starting where you wanted me to start. I'm apologizing for not starting where you wanted me to start. My point was that you called another crusty bitch mother. My point was that... Oh, you don't care about my point. Well... You know what your dad told me? And I hate to bring him up. The dumbest thing your father, shut up, Tiani, I'm talking. The dumbest thing your father ever told me when we were having an argument. Sounds like exactly what you just said. He said, my dad cheated on my mom, and now I cheated on you. So it sounds like what you're saying is, if I don't care about your point, whether it's valid or not, you're not going to care about my point, whether it's valid or not. Part of giving respect is understanding that while I love you very much, and you are my child, who I had out of my own coochie, cootie coot, pain, aggravation, and all, it sounds like you think you're on the same level as me. Let me finish my thought without you interrupting, if you please. It sounds like you think that no matter what somebody does, no matter how successful they are, no matter how much they earn, that as soon as they fail, you're out. That's what you just taught me. It came from the part about 10 minutes ago when you said, I'm not going to apologize for being homeless, number one. Is this how you argue with your friends? You've got supreme arrogance that I didn't give you, and I don't want to continue this anymore. Don't. The way that you argue is offensive.